somebody Happy Easter. Tell the Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Come on, rock the house. Come on, rock the house. Rock it. Oh, yeah. Come on and give the Lord the highest praise. Hallelujah. Clap your hands, all ye people. Shout unto the Lord with the voice of triumph. Shout unto the Lord with the voice of triumph. Come on, Pentecost. Come on, Pentecost. Oh, something down inside of me telling me to go ahead. Something down inside of me telling me to go ahead. Something down inside of me telling me to go ahead. Go ahead. Oh, something down inside of me. Something down inside of me. Something down inside of me. Go, go, go. Oh, Holy Ghost down inside of me. Holy Ghost down inside of me. Holy Ghost down inside of me. Go, go. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down. Come on, let me hear you.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Since I laid
my
burden down. I feel better, I feel better. So much better. Since I laid my
burden down.
I feel better. So much. Since I laid burdens down, Lord. Burdens down, Lord. Since I lay
burdens down, Lord. Burdens down, Lord.
Since I lay burdens. Oh, there's something down inside of me is telling me. There's something down inside of me telling me. Something down. It's in the inside. Go. Something down inside of me. It's on the inside. Telling me. You can make it. Telling. Now come on, let's put our hands together. Good to see you, Sister Wanda. God bless you. Something down inside of me.
Telling me, go ahead.
It's talking to me. It's telling me I can do it. I can do all things. Yeah. But you gotta lay the sin down. Glory. Hallelujah. Since I laid my
burden down.
Glory, glory.
Glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Since I laid my
burden. Now give him a Pentecost praise. Come on. All right, Sister Stephanie. Yeah. Go. Go ahead. Let's do it again. Something down inside of me, and it's telling me. Yeah, there's something down that's on the inside. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Now give him a hand clap of praise. A hand clap of praise. One more time. Something down inside of me. Telling me something. Telling me something down. Tell somebody he got up. Tell somebody he got up. Find you a third person. He got up. And how did he do it? He had all. Come on, get your three good jumps. Tell your neighbor we're gonna rock the house today. Hey, God! Come on, where my Pentecostals at? Yeah, God! He's alive and well. Somebody say yeah! Come on, loosen up in here. Yeah! All right, that feels better. Let's greet Psalmist Vaughn by saying, God bless you.
Somebody give him glory.
Hallelujah.
Somebody give him honor.
Glory.
Come on, tell somebody he's not dead.
He's not dead.
He's alive. Oh, I can feel him in my hand.
Yeah.
I can feel him in my feet. Look at your neighbor, tell him I can feel him all. Somebody ask him, come on in, Jesus. Come on in. Come on, Seth. Hallelujah. He's alive. Woo! Clap your hands like this. Come on. Can we rock like this? Come on. Let's rock like a choir. Jesus, we need your power. Somebody say, Jesus, we want your power.
We need your power
to fall fresh in this place. Pour out your Holy
Spirit
upon all flesh in this place.
We need your power
to fall fresh in this place.
Hey.
Voices in this place. We want to be loved. This is holy ground. This is holy ground. Hey! Woo! This is... Oh, yeah, no, no, no. Oh, God. This is holy ground. This is holy ground. Consuming fire. Sweet love you. Your eyes are bright. Feels this room. This is holy ground. This is holy ground. My God. This is holy ground. So we are standing on holy ground, and I know that there are angels all around. Let us run.
Surely the Lord is in this place.
I hear the late Bishop Norman L. Wagner say anything wonderful can happen. When he's exalted, they told us when the praises go up. Well, I thought I was in a Pentecostal church. The praises come. All right, you may be seated. I feel the Lord stretching out in me. You see, I cleaned up my house. We got any clean houses? And I kicked the devil out. I feel the Lord stretching out in me. You may be seated in your prayed up seat. I want you to know your seat was prayed for. We ask God whatever you stand in need of. When you sit down, it be yours. Woo! They told us whatever you need, God's got it. Whatever you need. Need more joy. You need more peace. It's yours today. Whatever you need. They also told us, turn it over to Jesus. He can work it out. Because can't nobody do me like the Lord. I like this part. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Why? He's. That's my friend. Well, he picked up and he told me to run on. He picked me up and he told me to run on. Picked me up and he told me to run on. He. All right. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. He. Now put your hands together real quick. Welcome to Hope Assembly, the happiest church on earth. All right, y'all be seated. They said ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party. Because when the Holy Spirit get to moving, you can get up to preach, but God's going to have his way. Oh, he's my friend. One more time. He's my friend. Yeah. Tell somebody now, we need a word from the Lord. We need a word from the Lord. Say, send your word, God. Send it on down. Oh Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. Send it on down. Send it on down. Lord, let your Holy Ghost come on down. All right. Power.
Power, Lord.
Power.
Power, Lord.
Power to walk right.
Power, Lord.
All right, I'm going to be good. We got a power, message Lord. To preach.
Power, Lord.
No. We need it, we need it.
Power, Lord.
I need it, I need it.
Power,
you need it, you need it.
Power,
we need it, we need it.
Power.
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 Power. All right, I gotta save some voice
power,
to preach.
Lord.
Y'all try to be good. We rocking the house.
Power, Lord. Power, Lord.
right, let's go to 2 Corinthians. Let's tell somebody, I got the Holy Ghost.
I got the Holy Ghost.
Deep down in my soul.
Just like the Bible says.
Just like the Bible says. Been to the river, and I've been baptized. Soul feels converted. Just like. I remember the day. I remember the very hour when he filled me with his power. And I've been running for Jesus a long time. I'm not tired yet. All right, come on now, y'all. Sit down. I'm not tired yet. Oh, no. I'm not tired yet. Oh, no. I'm not tired. All right, come on, y'all. We got a word from the Lord today. Y'all be seated. Woo. Yeah. All right, there we go.
I'm not tired yet.
Said there's a word from the Lord.
There's a word from the Lord.
Ah, yes. I feel God in this place. I know the power of God. And if you need your life changed, if you will give your life to God, he will change your ways. Is it the Hawkins that said, it'll make you do right when you want to do wrong? What is this? I had a few people try my patience this week. Ran into a few crazy people in the stores and places like this. But I'm determined to walk with Jesus. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Through hard trials, tribulation, persecution, what do? We'll be faithful. I'm determined. You know, I'm so happy he chastens those whom he loves. Just trying to get that no good joker out of you. Well, come on, Zion, say amen. When he comes back, you got to be ready. So God deals with the hard stuff. You know what I'm talking about. Can't nobody tell you about you like Jesus. Because we can come to church on Easter, and that's good. It's a wonderful thing. It shows that you have respect. But he wants our total life. From morning to night. You know, the foundational saints, they used to say this, and I wondered about it. They said, I've been saved all day, and I'm glad. You've been there? All day. Let's go to the word of the Lord. I asked the Lord what we were going to talk about as a church today. And Bishop, I had prepared a message that the blood is in the sky. And Dr. Gregory had it ready. Oh, but about midnight, there was a change. And the Lord said, I know you got that ready. You can do that another week. I did give it to you. But it's not the one for today. And I had the rainbow ready and the sun and the moon and the stars and rainbows. I just had it all ready. But he took me to 2 Kings, the 13th chapter, starting at the 14th verse. This is about Elisha. Now Elisha was fallen strict. He was fallen sick of his sickness whereof he died. And Joash, the king of Israel, came down unto him and wept over his face and said, oh, my father, the chariot of Israel and the horsemen thereof.
And Elisha said unto him, take bow and arrows. And he took it unto him, bow and arrows, and he said to the king of Israel, talking to the president, put thine hand upon the bow. And he put his hand upon it. And Elisha put his hand upon the king's hand. Tell your neighbor, pray for your leaders. And he said, open the window eastward. And he opened it. Then Elijah said, shoot. And he shot. And he said, the arrow of the Lord's deliverance and the arrow of deliverance from Syria. For thou shalt smite the Syrians till thou hast consumed them. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And he said, take the arrows. And he took them. And he said unto the king of Israel, smite upon the ground. Now, he had already seen what he was telling him, the symbolicness of this. And he took them, and the king said, smite upon the ground. And he smote thrice and stayed. And the man of God got upset. He was wroth with him and said, thou shouldest have smitten 5 or 6 times. Then hast thou smitten Syria till thou had consumed it. Whereas now thou shalt be smitten thrice. And Elisha died on a deathbed. Right. Having to rebuke somebody on a deathbed. What a scene. And they buried him. And the bands of the Moabites invaded the land at the coming in of the year. And it came to pass, as they were burying a man, that behold, they spied of men, and they cast the man into the sepulcher of Elisha. And when the man was let down, he touched the bones of Elisha. He revived and stood on his feet. Come on, say glory. Glory. Don't do it 3 times. Glory, 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 glory. Ah, you better catch this word. Get your bow and arrow. Shout glory. We go from glory to glory to glory to glory. I hope y'all catching it already. It's got to leap in your spirit today. I said, Father, what are you talking about? Around 2 this morning, he said, I'm talking about slack-handedness. I said, I hear you, God. He said, there's a slack-handedness in my church worldwide. They go to church. Skip 3 weeks, skip a year, come for 4 weeks, come for a year, skip 3 months, slack. Our gospel churches don't have choirs no more because folks don't want to be committed to rehearsing. But we will be committed to sports. Tell them we got to buy a robe. Well, the church ought to pay for it, but you pay for a football uniform. I'm talking about slack in your walk with God. I said, God, what are you saying? He said, Gregory, I'm talking about folks that are skip remembering me in communion. I don't have time on Good Friday. God asked me to ask folks, what were you so busy with that you couldn't remember me? And if it wasn't for me, you never would have woken up. I'm talking about slack. What were you doing? Seek ye first the kingdom He'll give you a house you can't afford. I can't afford a $2 million house right now, but he sure put me in one. 1 from room to room to room. What you can't do if you will seek God first is what I'm trying to show you. These things that you want, he'll give them to you. But it's not until your affection is upon things above and not beneath. Anyway, you bless me. Am I in a church today? Anyway, you bless me, I'll be. You see, he said, whatever state you're in, be content. He said, I know how to live meagerly, and I know how to live rich. But one thing I know, he's an on-time God. I wish I had a church there. He may not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time. He's working on your patience so it can have a perfect work and you lack nothing. Well, God. But I'm also happy when I see the lukewarm church. I'm seeing the choirs missing all over. I'm seeing mega churches that seat 5,300 people on Sunday. Used to be full. But I'm beginning to get happy. Because he said, when you see the sign of a lukewarm church, look up. I wish I had a church there. But see, you gotta wanna look up. You've got to be watching. But sometimes when we hear this, folks begin to say, but I want to get married first. I haven't had that house that I want. There's a house not built with hands. The maker is God. And the citizens of heaven, you don't have to worry about hatred. Haters that are jealous and been in your church for years and jealous of the pastor and jealous of the first lady and jealous of the deacon, jealous of the mother, jealous of the father in the church. So blind, can't see yourself. God said, ask people. Now, he told me, don't speak against live stream. So I'm not speaking against live stream. But when I quote the scripture, that when you see the day approaching, am I in his word? He said, even more so, get to the house of the Lord. Now, I didn't knock live stream. You have people who are sick and shut in. You have people who are in states that they don't have a church because they ain't no good pastors. That's why the Lord told me, don't lock live stream because I got no good pastors called themselves. And the people are having to search for something real. But he did say, when you see the day approaching, he said, get to the house of the Lord even more. So those of you who are on live stream, say Happy Easter. But the Spirit of God would ask me to ask you, what has you at home? Well, I know it's feeling cloudy in that home right now. He's been teaching us. Well, I'm here with my family. He said that if you love your mother or father more than me, you're not worthy for heaven. But he needs me. If you love them more, am I making this up? He said, if you love them more than you love me, depart from me. Who are you? I don't know you. Oh, but I'm on the intercessory prayer team. Put them off. Something's wrong. When you skip the things of God for things and people. Let's move forward. Because it's heavy, ain't it? See, the church is not just here to pat you on the back. God wants to clean you up. And whatever has you not ready, God wants you to be ready when he comes. He said, I would that nobody be lost. I want you to make it. When you hear this kind of message, it's not to tear you down, it's to prepare you to go. Now listen, now he gave me something that made me leap at around 3 a.m. and I said, oh God, I hope I'm not waking nobody up. I was sitting on my bed, and when God gave me this, I got up and had to just run a little bit. I said to the Lord, if Elisha's body had the power to resurrect something dead, then why ain't it him? Why don't you get up? Why's it got to be the dead man? Why? The Lord said two things, Gregory. He said, I wanted people to see that it pays to live holy. Saints, it pays to live holy. Tell somebody, you know he can answer prayers from the grave. Somebody prayed, had me on their mind. Bishop Wagner took the time to pray for me. He's over in glory, but the prayers are still being manifested right now. Tell somebody, my mother prayed for me. My father prayed for me. My aunt prayed for me, and it's alive. You may be seated. You may be seated. He said two things. Well. Lord, I thank you. I said, oh, well, what's the second thing? And the Lord said to me, and this is when I got up, Bishop, and start running around the house. He said, what I also wanted them to see, when you finish your course right, you don't want to come back. To live is Christ. To die is gain. Oh, I got excited about that. When you do it right, it's so good on the other side, somewhere over in glory. He said, you won't want to come back. That's why he stayed. The power is still in his bones, but he's in another place and he don't want to come back. I got so happy because I got a grandmother over there. And I looked at her picture sitting on my dresser, and I said, oh my God, you over there having a good time. St. Paul said it this way, for I am in a strait betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body so that we can be present with the Lord. I come to encourage all of us on Easter who loved ones have gone on to glory. It's so good, they don't want to come back. Somebody shout glory. There's a city called heaven. A city called heaven. I'm fast forwarding a little bit. I want to make it. Help me to make it to that city called. And then they said, there's a savior called Jesus. Now I want y'all to help me here. He then gave me instructions for the church today. And he began to show me some things about after Easter. And I sat there and God began to show me some future stuff in the future. And he said, tell the saint, I need you to pick up the bow and arrow today. But today, it's going to be a shot for souls. So he said to me, tell Section A to stand and face north. He said, tell Section B, stand and face south. Tell Section C, stand and face west. Tell Section D, stand and face east. And on the pulpit, we can just stand. Now, I was mindful not to say on the count of three, because he smote thrice, and God said you should have done it 5 to 7 times, you know. So on account of that, I said, all right, then on the count of five, we're going to shoot the arrow for souls. Are y'all beginning to get this? He gave me this that now today I'm going to use this in a different way with the saints, because the effectual, am I in the house? Fervent prayer of the righteous, it avails much. And the hour is getting late and God's coming sooner than you think. And he said, I need the church now to come out of a slack state. Get your bow and arrow and shoot this arrow for souls. On the count of five, I want you to shoot the arrow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shoot the arrow of the Lord's gospel. Shoot the arrow of baptism. Shoot the arrow of infilling. Shoot the arrow of repentance. Shoot the arrow of God's grace. Shoot the arrow of mercy. Shoot the arrow for the sin sick. Shoot the arrow of redemption. Shoot the arrow of the blood. The blood. It still works. The blood. The blood. Shoot the arrow of Emmanuel. Yeah. 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 Come on, cry for the souls. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins. Sinners plunge beneath the blood, lose all their guilty stains. Shoot the arrow. Shoot the arrow of the Lord's gospel. Now, army of the Lord, face north. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. You got to put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, rulers of darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take the whole armor of the Lord. Now, the Lord said, tell my army to face north. Now we're going to smite the ground with our feet. Get ready to take me into a praise break, musicians here. Tell your neighbor, now our assignment is to smite the ground with our feet. Now, remember here in the scripture, he only did it 3 times. And God said, the more you would have done it, the more victories. Remember that. So I want us to join hands across the aisle. Come on, army, come on, army, come on, army. This will represent the souls and victories. On the count of five, I want you to begin to smite the ground with your feet for the souls. One, two, three, four, five. Come on, saints. Come on, saints. It's for the souls. Come on, saints. Come on, soul winners. Here we go. Now loose your neighbor's hand and go into a praise. Yeah. Yeah. Come on, musicians. Come on. How many of you got a loved one that needs to be saved? Nike, praise him for the children. Now come on, saints, shoot the arrow for the backslider. Come home. Come home. Come home. Shoot the arrow for the backslider. Smite it with your feet. Come home. Backslider, say come home. Shoot, spike, shoot the arrow, spike. Yeah. Again. You got to jump in the spirit. How many of you have a loved one that needs God? How many of you have a loved one that needs God? I want you to shoot an arrow for them. Do it now. Smite. Bring them home. Now listen. Stay right there. Then God said this to me. Tell your neighbor, you don't know this. But God said while we were doing the work, I was going to heal diseases. Hey! Hey! You see, when you do God's business, he'll do the rest. Well, I'm done preaching, y'all. Come on, let's take 3 more minutes and praise him. It's about the kingdom and all his righteousness. For the souls in the name of Jesus. As the deacons come now. Bring ye all the tithing into the storehouse. This is your time to bring your tithing and offering. Let's move now. You can give online. Yeah! offering it to the Lord in the name of Jesus. Now thank him for giving you finances. Yeah. Only do it. Hallelujah. Come on, saints, are you excited? Come on, let's rock the house one more minute. Come on, Sister Lucretia. Yeah, come on, put your hands together. Tell your neighbor, I got one more arrow for the souls. I got one more smite. Come on, shoot! Smite! Come on and give God a hand clap of praise. I can tell the world about this. I can tell the nations I'm blessed. Tell them that the Comforter has come. You may be seated. Tell them that Jesus has come. It's joy. Saints, it's time to do the work. Now, partially what God showed me, that if the saints will do the work, the house will be filled. Y'all hear what I'm saying? If the saints, he showed me this. But see, we always waiting for God to do it with pixie dust. Mm-mm. It's in you. Faith without doing the work is there. Do the work. Now on Good Friday, we had our communion. And during communion, we pass out beautiful lapel pins for the people to wear. We still have some for those who weren't able to come. And I'm just going to ask our bishop and elect lady, if they'll just come stand here, they're there to pass out. If you would like one of those pins, you can come and stand in this aisle to my left, and you can receive one of the pins for Easter. And while they do that, Sister Lucretia is here today. She's a newer member of Hope Assembly, the happiest church on earth. Her husband pastored. Her husband went on to glory. And she took the mantle and pastored the church until she came here to be with us. And today she's going to sing a song that her cousin, Andre Crouch, wrote, The Blood. Greet her by saying, God bless you.
bless you.
Put your hands together for Sister Creed.
Never lose his power. But we won't do that. Lose his power. Oh, oh, the blood. It'll never lose his power. No matter how deep you sin, it covers. It'll never lose his power. That's all right. Somebody clap your hands for Jesus. Tell somebody it'll never lose his power. And you can still call on his name. Because he's on the main line. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Clap your hands. Mix up the song a little bit. It's an old song, but we fix it up a little bit. You might know it. Jesus is on the main line. Tell him
what you want.
You better tell. Better I feel. It's on the main line. Tell him what you want. You better tell him
what you want.
Oh, Jesus. It's on the main line. You better tell him
what you want.
You better tell him.
All right, Psalmist Vaughn. Lord have mercy. Have you enjoyed the Easter service or the benediction? Let's receive the Lady of Hope by saying, God bless you today.
Oh man, let's put our hands together for our beautiful Jesus. Come on, for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna, blessed be my King, my King, my King, my everlasting Father, my Prince of Peace, the King of Glory, the Bridge of a Troubled Water. Come on. Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock, blessed be the rock, my King, my King, my King, my King. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus, for the heavyweight champion of the world. Come on, come on, for the heavyweight champion in this corner, the heavyweight champion of the world. To the north, the heavyweight champion of the world. To the south, the heavyweight champion of the world. To the west, the heavyweight champion of the world. To the east, the heavyweight champion of the world. Put your hands together for Jesus. Oh, glory, 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 hallelujah. To the risen King. Oh, hey, hey. Glory, hallelujah to the risen King. Hey, glory. Woo, glory. Oh, glory, hallelujah. All right now, they're ready. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah to the risen King. Who do you call? Wonderful Counselor. Oh, 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 glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah to the risen King. What's his name? What's his name? The name of your King, Jesus. This morning, Numbers, the fifth chapter, verses 24 through 26. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Amen, 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 amen. May Lord ever add a blessing to the reading of his word. And I was looking at this quote, and I've been looking at it on and off during the week, and I just think it's so cute, and I just want to leave it with you as you walk this prosperous week. Amen. I want you to have a wonderful week. I want you to have a prosperous week. Amen. No complaining, no murmuring. All right. Amen. Amen. Because we've had some good days. We've had some hills to climb. That's right. But when we think it over, all of our good days, I'll weigh my bad days and I won't complain. Come on, Carrie. God's been good to me. The Lord has been so good to me.
Better than this world
could ever
be.
Yes.
He's been good.
He's been good
to me.
To me.
My tears away.
My God.
And he turned all my midnight into day. So I lift my hands and said, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. I will
complain.
Nobody sing it like him. So So don't complain, people. Don't complain. Don't complain, amen. Amen, because God has been good to us, and all of our good days outweigh our bad days, amen. And we have no reason to complain. Culinary has prepared a little sweet treat. They have some little sweet cupcakes back there for you. So before you leave, make sure to just stop by and pick up one of the sweet treats. Amen. And this quote that I like, it says, when people bring up your past, tell them Jesus dropped all the charges. Amen. Glory to God. Glory. Can the church say amen? Amen. May God be with you. And as I tell you every week, walk in the FOG, in the favor of God. Amen. May God prosper you. May he bless you. Amen. May he open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive it. Come on, open up your hands and just receive it. Receive your healing. Receive those financial blessings. Receive those promotions. Receive healing in your relationships. Healing in your homes. Come on. Oh, God, I receive it. Hallelujah. God bless you. Have a wonderful weekend. Walk in the FOG. I love you to life. God bless you.